Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In this lesson, we are going to look at the Arabic vowels. As you have learned earlier, there are 28 Arabic letters. And all of these letters are consonants. There are two types of Arabic vowels. First is the short vowels, and second is the long vowels. Let us look at the short vowels. Arabic language is unique in the sense that the short vowels are not represented by letters. Instead, it is represented by certain symbols. So there are three symbols which are used to indicate short vowels. So let us take an example. So this letter, ba. Okay, the ba letter. The first vowel that you will see is this symbol. It is put above the letter. The name of this symbol is fatha, fatha, and it is equivalent to a sound. So when I have this letter ba, okay, with this fatha, so it becomes ba, ba. So ba sound with fatha a, it becomes ba. The next symbol that you will see is this. It is put below the letter. The name of the symbol is kasra, kasra. So when you have a kasra, it is e. So here the letter ba together with a kasra, it sounds b. And the third vowel or the third symbol that you will see is this. This is put above the letter and it is u sound. So when you have ba, the letter ba, together with this dhamma symbol, so now you say bu. So here we have ba, bi, bu. Now we move on to the long vowels. So for the long vowels, it is very similar to the short vowels. You are using the three symbols again, the fatha, the kasra, and the dhamma. But now, since it is a long vowel, you will not read ba, bi, bu. Instead, you will say ba, bi, bu. And for the first long vowel, you will need this fatha and the letter alif. So the alif here is no longer a consonant. It is just to make the fatha a long sound. So here we say ba. The second long vowel is you need the kasra and also another letter, which is the ya. So again, this ya is no longer a consonant. The ya will make the kasra longer. So instead of b, now you say b. And the third long vowel is by having the dhamma together with the letter waw. So by having a dhamma with the letter waw, you will say oo, and in this example it is boo. And since the Arabic alphabets are supposed to be joined together, so here instead of ba and alif written individually, you will see that they will be written together. So this is now ba. Ba and the ya will look like this. B. And ba and the waw will look like this. Boo.